everyone. I'm going to show you how we measure density using a hydrometer and a couple of graduated cylinders. So you can see I have my graduated cylinders on a metal tray to keep from spilling water everywhere. The tables at the Marine Center are electrified, so we always try to contain the water in case there's a spill. This graduated cylinder contains salt water, which I've labeled with an S for salt. And this one contains fresh water, which remember means water with no salt in it. So I've written that on there as well. To use a hydrometer, we've got the weight at one end and a scale at the other. So the weighted end goes into the graduated cylinder and we have some water overflow, that's fine. That's why we have the metal tray. And then what I want to look at is where the water crosses the scale. Now you can see the water's rising up a little bit along the scale. That's called the meniscus. It's where it's caused because water molecules like to hang out with each other. But essentially, I'm going to add a little more so we can see a little more clearly. Little more water. There we go. And what we want to do is look right where that water line is crossing the scale. So we are crossing, it looks like one line below that green square that you can see right here. So at the top of the square, it's 1.020. And then every line after that is 0.002. So the first line in the green bar would be 1.022. The second would be 1.024. And the third one, which is sort of where we are, is going to be 1.026. So our density of salt water is going to be 1.026. And that's what you would write down in your lab. Now we're going to do the same thing with the fresh water. So I put in my hydrometer. If I was good, I'd rinse it off in between, but we're not going to. And you can notice the hydrometer sinks down a lot further, right? In the first one, we had the green that was all the way up at the top, and now the green is way underwater. And we can see we're essentially right at the top of the scale at 1.000, maybe 1.002. But if we got rid of some of those air bubbles, it would probably take care of that. So our density of fresh water is 1.000, which is exactly what it should be.